Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Don, and today we're going to be doing something a little different here on the channel. So today we're going to be taking a look at a non-VR product. I know, you guys are probably going, dude, Don, are you okay? Because you only do VR. Well, you know, I was contacted by this company, Pants Night, a couple of weeks ago, and they were like, hey, you know, would you review our little Google Cardboard clone headset? And I had to respectfully decline because I love all VR, but I really think we are past the days of shoehorning our phones into plastic boxes on our faces. And then they came back and they were like, well, would you review our projector? And I started thinking to myself, well, you know, do I really want to do that? I am a VR-only channel. So I started racking my brain, you know, how could you tie a projector into VR? And it hit me. Boom, the Oculus Quest. So all week I've been demoing my Quest to people at work, and we're all crowding around my phone screen because that's one of the few places that you can cast this to. And I'm like, wow, okay, boom, yeah, a projector. So I started researching this. I hit the webpage. It does say that you can plug a Chromecast into the HDMI port. I know you could already plug in a computer with the HDMI port. And I thought, all right, this works. So it's a viable thing that you could carry to parties or demo nights and show up on a wall without having to have everybody crowd around your phone screen. So let's go ahead and take a look at the webpage. Let's take a look at the specs of the projector. And then I'm going to get it all hooked up and we will take a look at it in action. So let's go. All right. So here we are on the web page or the Amazon page for the Pansonite mini portable projector. And, you know, looking at the specs, it actually looks pretty good on paper. So, you know, you're going to see right there in the headline, your 3000 lux, 50,000 hour lamp life, full 1080p, max 200 inch display. Well, yeah, it's not going to be what you see in the headlines there, guys. So really, you know, this is something that's kind of gotten under my skin, and I do want to rant about it for a minute. This, calling these projectors full 1080p, it's kind of false advertising, in my opinion. Now, granted, anybody who thinks they're going to get a 1080p projector for under $100, well, you're insane. But, you know, right here, you can see it, native resolution, 800 by 480. So obviously doing a hell of a lot of upscale. It's just one of those things that don't come into this thinking that you are going to get a true crisp 1080p image. It's just not going to happen. So, you know, it does have multiple devices you can connect to it, though. I mean, you do HDMI, USB, it'll play right off of sticks. I put a movie on it the other night for the kids. It's got VGA, which, well, nobody actually has that anymore. The standard audio-video interface for, like, older game systems. It can do Amazon Fire Sticks. I did a Roku device on it the other day. Like I said, I don't have a Chromecast to test it with, but it should do Chromecast just fine, which will allow complete native casting from the Quest straight to the projector. You know, it does have a decent brightness, the 3,000 lumens. I can buy that. It you don't have to fully turn off the lights to actually see the picture. However, that is based on the screen size. If you get up to this 200-inch display, you're definitely going to want to be in a pitch black room to do that. The 3,000:1 contrast ratio, I'm going to call a little BS on that. These are always made up numbers. I used to work at Radio Shack. Trust me, contrast ratios are not standardized. Just like, you know, in the VR world, you know, the whole FOV thing is not standardized. Those are kind of made up numbers by the people who put this stuff out here. It does have a built-in speaker. Sounds like crap, not gonna lie. It is what it is. It's exactly what you'd expect for a sub $100 projector with a speaker built in. And it does come with a 5-year warranty, though, and a free VR gift, which is probably the little Pansonite headset that they originally asked me to review. And they do actually give you a 100% money back guarantee. So, you know, if you buy the thing, I mean, Pansonite's going to cover you. You know, so I don't know. It is what it is. So, all right, let's go ahead and get the thing hooked up and see if I can throw a little Quest footage and see if I can get a little video of me using it and show you guys. Okay, so
So here we are. We are actually in the headset now, and you can see it is being broadcast through the little Panasite projector up onto my wall. Now, you know, a couple things. My wall is kind of almost like grayish white, so it's not the best surface to be projecting this on. And, you know, because I am recording this video, I do have to leave the lights on a little bit. Otherwise, my camera doesn't work very well. But, you know, you've got the lights here at 25% brightness, and you can see you're still getting a pretty decent image back there on the wall. Obviously, this thing does work best if the lights are completely off, but that's up to you. You know, it will work with the lights on. So I don't really know what more to say about this. I know I am on a wire here. You know, it does have an HDMI port. It should work with Chromecast, and then you can do the direct casting. I don't understand why Oculus has restricted that to just your phone and a Chromecast device. So, you know, if I could have done this to a Roku or to another device of my choice, then, you know, obviously I could have shown you guys how this works wirelessly. But that's it. I guess let's get to some final thoughts, because it definitely works.
All right, so there you have it, the Panasonic Mini Portable Projector. And I gotta say, you know, it is what it is. It's a sub $100 projector. It's not gonna be a blistering, crisp HD image, but if you're just looking for something cheap to throw in your bag with your Quest to take with you to parties, man, this actually works. So, you know, I can see a lot of advantage to just having the Chromecast in the side, doing the native streaming over to it from your Quest, so that people aren't standing around your phone screen and crowding you. That way they can all stand around a wall and crowd that and watch you play in the Quest. So I am going to throw a link for this down in the description if you want to grab one for yourself. But for me, that's going to do it, guys. This is Don. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.